Hello and welcome everybody. In this tutorial, I will show you how to add your analog devices as external effect plugins into your DAW. In this way, you set up your own effects plugin to call in hardware units like analog compressors, EQs, and effects units in your channel strip like any other software plugin. Let's see how we do it. I'll be using VLA Pro II analog compressor here, and my audio interface is Focusrite 18i8. And of course, I use Cubase Pro 10.5. It is important to mention here that your audio interface should have at least 4 line outputs and minimum 2 inputs. If your interface has only 2 outputs, I'm afraid you can't use the method demonstrated here. So, this is my setup. This is my VLA Pro 2. I really like this compressor. It's one of the best for that price range. I got Cubase 10.5 in my MacBook and Focusrite 18i8. I'm not planning to discuss in detail about the individual units. That's not the purpose of this video. And I got Yamaha HS5 as my monitors. I came up with an illustration of hardware wiring so that you can understand this easier. First and foremost, you need to have the USB cable connecting your computer to your audio interface for the data transfer. Then generally output 1 and 2 are reserved for your speakers for monitoring, as shown here. This is the reason why you cannot use an audio interface with only 2 outputs. Those 2 outputs has to be used for monitoring. Then you use another 2 outputs to send the data received by the audio interface via USB cable to the analog device, as shown here. You can see here the output 3 and output 4 are going into the inputs of VLA Pro 2. So that is our send signal of the circuit done. So these send signals will be processed in the analog device, and then we receive that signal again back from the output of the analog device into the input of the audio interface. You can use any available input. Here I'm using the input slot 3 and 4 for this demonstration. So hopefully you understand the process with this illustration. And if I show you the signal path, it will be more easier. So data comes with the USB cable into the audio phase, and then the send signal is sent to the analog device through outputs 3 and 4. And the return signal comes out of the analog device into the audio interface and back to the DAW via USB cable. Now let's see how we do this in the actual setup. Here in the back panel of the Focusrite, I got 4 inputs and output 1 and 2 already connected to the speakers, and I have output 3 and 4 for my analog connections. I have already made the USB connection. Here I have my TS cables which are going into these outputs, so I can send the same signal to the analog device. Now the 2 free ends of the 2 audio cables are going into the input of channel 1 and channel 2 of VLA Pro. As you can see here, I have 2 XLR cables already plugged in to the outputs of channel 2 and channel 1 of my VLA Pro, which will in turn go back into the audio interface as inputs. You can see the input cables in here, in input 3 and 4, which will take the return signal back into the DAW via the USB cable. Now let's go into the computer and do our software setup. I have a project open in Cubase to demonstrate this. So now we have to set up the external effects plugin. Go to Studio, Audio Connections, and then click on External Effects. You can see that I have already have 2 effects which I'm gonna delete so that we can start from the beginning to demonstrate this. So External Effects, and then you press the Add External Effects, and then you can name it there. So I'm gonna name it as VLA Pro to stereo, and both send and return configurations are stereo. So let's press OK That's it. And then we need to connect our audio interface to this. So it says not connected. Click on that. And then you can select our send bus, Scarlett, that is my audio interface, and output 3 and 4 are already connected there, because output 1 and 2 are used for monitoring. So, and then our return bus, again my audio interface, and it should be input 3 and 4, because that is what we are using as you saw in our wiring. So that's it, that's all set up now for this stereo connection. While we are here, we can add a mono connection as well. Same process, so you can name it and then make sure send and return configurations are mono. So it's gonna be VLA Pro 2 mono. Press OK. And again, go back in there. We have to configure the send and return buses. Select the audio interface. And here, output, we don't have output 6, but for the demonstration purpose, we can select output 3 there. Like that. And then it will pop up saying that it's been used. That is because we have used it on for the stereo one. But never mind. So, and here, whatever the input that you want to choose. I will go back to my stereo one to reselect the output 3 and 4 and input 3 and 4. That's return bus, input 3 and 4. That's it. So that's all configured now. So we can close that dialog box. Now we go there, and just if you go into the Steinberg, and it'll be under the external plugins, you can see, and now you can load it like any other software plugin. There you go. And this little window will allow you to control your send and return gains of our external effects plugin. Now let's head back to our compressor to check the setup. Let's switch it on, and you can see the two channels on either side of the output meter with these controllers. And this button here, when you press that, both channels are linked to give a stereo signal. In Cubase, I'm going to reload the plugin, VLA Stereo. There it is, and it is deactivated now, and I'm going to start playback of this track. I hope you can hear this. Yes. You can hear the track with low volume. Let's activate it. Boom. Right now I'm playing with the output dial of the compressor, and you can hear the volume change accordingly. Go back to the compressor and keep an eye on the VU meters, and you will see the needle change when I change the output level. One thing to notice, when the two channels are linked in VLA, channel 1 will control both sides. So here you have your usual controllers, your threshold ratio, so you can dial in whatever the setting that you need to process your sounds and add some analog warmth to your instruments and in your master bus or mix bus. One final note, these effects plugins can only be used in a single channel at any given time. Once it is loaded into a channel, you can't use that into in another channel. If you want to use it in multiple channels, you will have to bounce the first channels that have been processed already and then use it on another channel. I hope this is useful and clear enough, and hopefully you can use your analog processors as shown here to make some beautiful music. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and like this video.